Let's pause real quick. We do have Daniel Hamry with his question on the screen.
Oh, yes, we do. We do. And there was a reason I put that up there. So Daniel's checking in concerning Jaylan Knighton.
Yeah. And, you know, he, again, is a top caliber recruit, you know, high school All-American, one of two players ever to have rushed for 5,000 yards in high school in Broward County history. He and the late, great Tyrone Moss at Pompalone Ely, God rest his soul, are the only two who've ever done that, 5,000 yards in a high school career in Broward County, Florida. Knighton was being heavily pursued by lots of teams, including O-State. He is doing well. He needs to be a rotation guy. He needs to be a touches guy, not a 25 carries between the tackles. You know, he's not a workhorse back. I'm sorry. He's a speed guy. You know, like, you're 5'10", 180 pounds. Like, you're not going to withstand that beating. And, like, yeah, for one game and everybody got injured and we weren't really comfortable going to anybody else and he had 33 carries, I want to say, cool. But, like, I don't think that he's ever going to get north of 25. I mean, it shouldn't even be really more than 22 carries in the game. But that being said, punt returns, kick returns, in the passing game, we've seen him score some long touchdowns on wheel routes. Because he has electric speed. And it seems like he's ready to take a step forward, because if he has the ability to hit full speed and make moves and change direction at full or near full speed, you know, I know that this was just held last week and I haven't got to watch it, but there was the F1 race at the Miami F1 the Miami Autodrome, or whatever they call it, that they built around Hard Rock Stadium. They built an F1 track. You got an F1 car on the field and Jaylan Knighton, if you're able to keep top speed and turn those corners and do those kind of things, like, he's an explosive player. And having a weapon like that, being able to use him out of the backfield, because he's scored long touchdowns on that slow mesh zone read, you know, that's akin to what Wake Forest does, you know, on just that tempo of really being slow, letting some stuff happen, bang, and I'm two steps to top speed, and then you're not going to catch me. You know, North Carolina got loose 2 years ago as a freshman against and the North Carolina that was on a swing route up the left sideline, and then made a cut. You know, gave him outside in, planted that left foot, you know, kind of juke move, and then there was a defender with an angle, and again, Jaylan Knighton being able to outrun that angle. The year before against Louisville, that was a wheel route. There was another game, had a wheel route for, you know, 70 or 80 yard touchdown. So an explosive player, multi-talented, like every running back, I think fancies himself to be a workhorse, but I think that he's best used in pace and space because he has electric speed, and we've seen it where guys, other elite athletes at the Power 5 level, even with a head of steam, even with an angle to cut him off, Jaylan Knighton is that kind of fast where that doesn't matter. And yeah, hopefully he's able to continue his progression and everything, but he's at or near the top of the roster at running back, a definite weapon in this offense and one that we will rely on often. So to the question, he's performed well. There's still room for growth, but he has electric ability and incredible potential, and hopefully he still is able to take an even further step forward on top of what he's already done.